Hey everyone, it's Kyle here with Tech Talk Tuesdays, joined by our special guest, Juan.
Hey, how's it going everybody? Onboarding director here at Feniex Industries.
We're here today to talk about the V3 Cannon we just released and the difference between V3, V2, syncing, what syncs with what, installations, show you a few new flash patterns, and introduce you to the product.
And as we go through this, please feel free to ask any questions. We'll answer them at the end.
Yeah. So we have a few talking points, a few things we want to go over, a few questions that we've gotten already about this new product. Just going to jump into it. So some of the questions we've gotten are, what are we calling these new products? Everything that we release now is going to have a label that says V3. You can't see it, I'm sure, but it's going to say V3 on it. And all the previous products are not going to have marking, so anything that says V3 is going to be able to sync with V3. So our Fusion surface mounts will say V3, we'll be able to sync with our Cannons that say V3. The V3 Cannon, in addition to new flash patterns and firmwares and syncing abilities with our V3 Fusion, we changed the circuitry. So this is our old Cannon right here, our V2, if you will. And it's got this inline driver. We got rid of that, and we took all that circuitry, and we put it into the single light head right here. So we shrunk it down and just kind of got rid of it, so you don't have to figure out where to put it when you're installing it. You can fit this through any installation holes that you're trying to install it in, so it's much smaller. For the syncing, we're going to have a diagram we'll link in the comments. You can check out. You can see what products will sync with what, if that's confusing to you at all, and kind of go over that. And if you have any questions, you can save them to the end. We're going to do a little Q&A. So I'm going to toss it back over to Juan to talk about bezels, installations, and whatnot.
Thanks, Kyle. So one of the questions that we get a lot is the Cannon V3 going to have a new bezel? And yes, it is going to have a smaller profile bezel as compared to the previous one. Now, these bezels are backwards compatible, so you can use the previous bezel on the new ones. So so you can mix and match them. So if you have a bunch of these, you can use them with the new V3 Cannons. Are the bezels available with purchase of a Cannon? Absolutely. They are available for purchase with a Cannon. And yes, they will be backwards compatible, as I mentioned. How do you decide which bezel to use? So when we sell a new V3 Cannon, and you request a bezel to go along with it, is going to come with the new bezel for the Cannon. Again, if you have a bunch of V2 bezels laying around, those will also fit. Where should you install the Cannons? I have a little diagram here of a vehicle. Basically, the Cannons can be installed anywhere on the vehicle, on the front of the vehicle, the side of the vehicle for visibility. They can also be installed on the inside cavity of the vehicle for reverse lighting as well. They have that dual functionality. So they're very versatile. They can be installed pretty much on any surface. So so what is another question that we get is, what is the difference between a single color and a dual color Cannon? The difference is that, obviously it's self-explanatory, but in terms of the amount of LEDs that are going to be on a Cannon, we have 12 LEDs on the Cannon only. As compared to our Fusion surface mount, the dual color has 12 LEDs, the single color has 6. In terms of the Cannon, 12 LEDs, now when you have a single color, all 12 LEDs are going to be the same color. When you have a dual color Cannon, 6 LEDs are going to be one color, 6 LEDs are going to be a separate color. So so that is basically the difference in how you get two colors on a Cannon. And I'll toss it over back to Kyle to go over some flashing pattern updates.
Yeah, so with this new V3 Cannon and the updated firmware for the Fusion, the V3 Fusion firmware, we did add a few new patterns, as well as a dim mode. So I'm gonna just kind of jump into it and show you guys here. So the Fusion is set to one of our new patterns. There's three new patterns total. You got Attack 1, which was kind of a favorite on our T3 product, if y'all familiar with those, and Attack 2, which were also on the T3. And then a request was to add a dim or a cruise mode to the new firmware. So you're gonna have your brake pop, your steady on, and then your dim mode. So here's the attack pattern. This is attack one. This is really good for, like, you know, really far distance. You want to see a lot of light movement. If you can sync it with another module on attack pattern, you can see a lot of great light movement. So that's the attack one. Here is the dim mode on the Cannon. The Fusion will have this as well. So this is a dual color. So both colors will have your dim mode available. So this is dim amber. That's at 25% brightness. And another question we're getting about these new firmwares is, will they work with our 4X flasher? So we're gonna be making a document showing what patterns they will work with our 4X flasher, and getting that out shortly to y'all. So it works with most patterns. There are three patterns in the flasher that these do not work with. So what you're gonna do to use it with the flasher is you set these products to steady on, and then tie them to the flasher, and they'll just flash like a normal kind of dummy module would. So yes, they do work with our flasher. Now the patterns, so we did change all of the patterns in these to be a little bit slower, and that was kind of to standardize with our competitors' products. So when you look at a Wayland or a Code 3, and you look at their patterns, they usually have 75 flashes per minute, 120 flashes per minute for slow and fast. So we looked at those and just standardized them, kind of industry standard patterns, slowed them down a little bit, and they look much better, a lot cleaner. So how do you sync Cannons with other Feniex products is another great question that we get a lot. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna basically just sync them just like any other product that we've made before. If you've used our products before, you tie the blue wire together, set one to a master, one to a slave, or you could do master, master, or slave, slave, and just power them up. So tie the grounds together, tie the modes, whatever mode that you want to use, set them to a pattern, whatever pattern you want to use, and just power them on, and then they'll be synced. So yeah. I think that covers all the new flash patterns, covers all the different firmwares and syncing options, mounting options. So,
yeah, looks like we already have some questions online. So let's get to those real quick. Let's see. Christoph, thanks for sending a question out to us. What is the best way to get an X pattern between four Cannons? Is there a way to get an X pattern between four Cannons?
Yeah, I mean, you can do a master slave configuration with four light modules, and you can have them just slow alternating. So have two synced and then the other two synced.
Yep. The next question is from Jesse. Jesse asks, will it sync with anything? Assuming that you are talking about perhaps any other product of Feniex's. Again, the label will contain the version that it will sync up with. So like, for instance, V3, the new Fusion Surface mounts will also have V3 as well. So those will sync up. Cal, do you have any other?
No, anything to add there. Eric Spitzer is asking, is dim mode coming to all products in V3? Yes, they are. Dual color, you'll be able to dim both colors, and the Fusion as well. V3 Fusion firmware will have dim in it as well.
Nick Fever, does the new firmware eliminate the units stepping on themselves in the off time?
Yes, it does, actually. That was one of the main things we were fixing here, was the triple flash, fast and slow, kind of step and stutter, and that's been fixed. We slowed them all down to kind of be more of an industry standard, 120 flashes per minute for fast and 75 flashes per minute for slow.
Let's see, we have Chris Goodman. Will the new surface mounts have three functions like the Cannons?
No, so the hardware didn't change with the Fusion Surface mounts, only the firmware did. So it's gonna have your two modes, four wires, your sync, ground, mode one, and mode two. The new V3 Cannon is going to have three modes, just like our old Cannon, and your sync wire and ground.
We have another question from Jonathan. Are single colors brighter than dual color? That's a very good question. Now, if we have 12 LEDs on a single color Cannon, it's going to seem perhaps a little brighter than when you have dual color, because dual color uses six modules on six LEDs on one color, six LEDs on another color. However, to the naked eye, it's almost indistinguishable. They're going to be extremely, extremely bright anyway. So thanks for the question. The new V3 has the flasher built into it, correct?
Correct. Yeah, it's a smart module just like the old one. So we just took this inline driver, which had the smarts in it and all the flash patterns, and we just shrunk that driver and down and put it to here. So you just set your flash pattern on your mode, you set your syncing, just the same functionality as you get in this our previous model.
And just think of the functionality here, guys, because this inline driver is not going to be there anymore. So it'll be easier to install these products. It'll be easier to maneuver this through any sort of cavity in the vehicle. So it's a huge improvement here. So
another question is, when will these be available? We have them in stock and are currently shipping them right now. What about tricolor is another question we've got. Right now, this is currently single and dual color only. I see another one that says, are you using the same LED that the surface mount is currently using? Yes, yeah, we're using the same Cree 4-watt LED for all the products you see here. So this is, you've got six of them on here on single color, 12 for dual color, six and 12 for single and dual color. Well, not seeing any more questions. I think we're gonna wrap it up. If y'all have any more questions, just feel free to comment. We'll try to get back to you on that. Thanks for joining us here today.
Appreciate it, guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.